हेलो स्टूडेंट, वेलकम टू द नेक्स्ट वीडियो ऑफ साइंस। ओके स्टूडेंट, इन दिस वीडियो वी आर गोइंग टू स्टडी अबाउट द टॉपिक हाउसिंग एंड क्लोथिंग। स्टूडेंट, एज यू ऑल नो दैट वी ऑल द लिविंग थिंग्स नीड अ प्लेस टू लिव। ओके, सो द प्लेस वेयर एन ऑर्गेनिज्म लिव इज नोन एज होम और द शेल्टर ऑफ दैट लिविंग ऑर्गेनिज्म। एज यू आर फैमिलियर विद अ काउ लिव्स इन अ शेड, हॉर्स लिव इन अ स्टेबल, हैन लिव्स इन अ केज, डॉग लिव्स इन अ कैनल। दिस ऑल यू हैव स्टडीड इन योर क्लास 1 and 2। ओके स्टूडेंट, एंड मैनी एनिमल्स सच एज मंकीज, बियर्स, दे लिव ऑन द ट्रीज। सो ट्रीज आर देयर होम और द शेल्टर। एंड यू ऑल्सो हैव, यू माइट हैव सीन बर्ड्स स्टेइंग ऑन द ट्रीज। बर्ड लिव ऑन द ट्रीज, सो ट्रीज आर देयर शेल्टर और द होम। ओके, सो all living organism needs a place to live, and the place where an organism live is known as shelter. Okay student, but the question is, why do we need a house? We stay in our house, but why do we need a house? Okay student, why do we need a house? We need a house to protect ourselves from heat. Okay, these days in summer, the days are very hot. Okay student, we can't stay outside for the whole day. So in the mid in the afternoon, we just sit inside our homes, and we use our fans, ACs and coolers. Okay student, so our house protects us from heat. Okay, our house protects us from cold, our house protects us from wind and rain. Student, you might have observed that whenever you are playing outside, if there is rain, then you just come inside your home or not? Yes or no? Yes, of course, when there is rain outside, you just come inside your home, you do not play in the rain. So our house protects us from the rain. Okay student, and wild animals, yes of course, if we don't have proper homes, then wild animals can attack us. Okay, so our house also protects us from wild animals. Okay, and thieves. Okay student, if we put all the essential things outside or in some open place, what will happen? The thieves will carry all the things. So we should have a proper place to live. Okay student, so why do we need a house? We need a house because house protects us from heat, cold, wind, rain, wild animals and thieves. Okay student, when it is in summer, in winters, in summers it is very hot. Okay, so what do? We can't play outside. In daytime, what do? We just sit inside our homes. We just open our AC, our coolers and our fans, and we just sit inside our homes. Okay, so in this way, our house protects us from heat. Okay, in winters, it is very cold. Sometimes it is very cold in winter. Then also, we just sit inside our homes and we use heaters. Okay, on our bed to keep ourselves warm, and we wear a lot of woolen clothes such as sweater, muffler, jackets, socks. Okay student, so our house protects from cold. Okay, students, you might have observed that sometimes there is a very strong winds blow, and the dust get inside our eyes, है ना? जब कभी आंधी तूफान आता है तो क्या होता है? धूल मिट्टी हमारी आँख में चली जाती है. Then again, what do? We just get inside our home. Yes or no? Yes, of course, we get inside our home. जब आंधी तूफान का मौसम होता है तो हम सब क्या करते हैं? अपने खिड़की दरवाजे सब बंद कर देते हैं. We just close our doors and windows, and we sit inside our house or get inside our house to keep ourselves from wind, strong wind. In the same way, our house protects
okay.
us.
In the same way, our house protects us from
heat, cold, wind, rain, thieves, and wild animals. Okay, student. And student, there are mainly two types of houses. Okay, one is temporary house and other is permanent house. Okay, permanent house. Permanent house is a house that is fixed at one place. Okay, we cannot shift it from one place to another place. Okay, student. As our doors and windows are fixed at one place, we cannot move them from their places. Okay, in the same way, permanent houses are fixed at one place. Okay, there are two types of permanent houses: kaccha house and pakka house. A kaccha house is made up of mud, straw, bamboo stick, and wood. Okay, and we see such types of houses mainly in village areas. Okay, and the pakka houses, a pakka house is made up of bricks, cement, iron, and steel. Okay, student. And we see such types of houses. Where we see pakka houses? We see pakka houses in cities. Okay, student. Now the temporary houses. Temporary means they are temporary place at one places. They can move from one place to another, or we can shift them from one place to another. As our furniture, we keep on moving our furniture from one place to another place. Okay. So they are temporary placed. In the same way, there are some temporary houses. Okay, a tent. Number one is a tent. A tent is made up of thick cloth. Okay, so a tent is made up of thick cloth. Soldiers and the peoples who keep on moving from one place to another, they use such types of houses. Okay, so the people who go for trekking, you might have heard TV में सुना होगा आप लोगों ने अपने किसी फ्रेंड से रिलेटिव से सुना होगा ना. द पीपल दोज हु गो फॉर ट्रैकिंग यूज दिस टेंट एंड इट इज़ वेरी कन्वीनियंट टू टेक इट फ्रॉम वन प्लेस टू अनदर. ओके स्टूडेंट. सेकेंड इज कैरावन. अ कैरावन इज अ हाउस ऑन व्हील. एज इट इज अ हाउस ऑन व्हील्स, इट हैज ऑल द फैसिलिटीज लाइक अ हाउस. इज लिविंग रूम, बेडरूम, किचन, ड्रॉइंग, डाइनिंग, एवरीथिंग इज देयर. ओके. And people who keeps moving from one place to another, they use this type of house. Okay, student. And now the houseboat. Houseboat, as the name shows, that it is a house on a boat. Okay. And a houseboat is a house that floats on water. A houseboat keeps floating on the water. Okay, student. And where we can see such houses? Yes, have you seen them somewhere? Yes, of course. In we see such houses in Kashmir and Kerala. You might have seen in some picture, or you have seen in TV also. Okay, student. आपने TV में देखा होगा. अगर आप घूमने गए होंगे कभी कश्मीर वगैरह, तो आपने वहाँ देखा होगा. Okay, student. So a houseboat is a boat that floats on water, and we see them in Kashmir and Kerala. Okay, student. And an igloo. And an igloo is made up of ice blocks. Igloos are made up of ice blocks, and igloos are found in very cold places. Okay, student. We are going to study the features of a good house. Okay, student. A good house should allow proper sunlight to come during the day. Okay, student. Why? Because sunlight helps to kill germs and keep our house free of germs. Okay, so how helpful is our sunlight for us? Sunlight helps to kill the germs and keep our house free of germs. Okay, second point is, a house should be well ventilated and airy. Okay, well ventilated and airy means there should be proper doors and windows. You might have seen your parents or the grandparents, they just open all the windows and doors in the morning. Why? So that, because the fresh air can enter in the house. Okay, student. So a house should be well ventilated and airy. Okay, student. A house should have, third point is, a house should have open space like veranda. Okay, and plant should be grown around our house. Why there should be plants around our house? Because plants helps to clean the air and give us fresh air to breathe. Okay, student. Why we should grow plants around our house? We should grow plants near our house because plants helps to clean the air and give us fresh air to breathe. Okay, student. Now the next point is doors and windows should have well fitted wire nets. Why doors and windows should have well fitted wire nets? To keep away insects like flies and mosquitoes. Okay, student. The doors and windows should have well fitted wire nets because to keep away flies and mosquitoes. Okay, student. And next point is our bathrooms and toilet should be cleaned properly. Okay, student. And the next point is garbage and the dirty water should not be allowed to collect at one place. Okay, garbage and the dirty water should not be allowed to collect at one place. Okay, student. So students, as we need a house to protect ourselves from heat, cold, wind, rain, thieves and wild insects. Okay, in the same way we need clothes to protect ourselves from heat, cold, wind, rain and insect bites. Okay, student, we all wear different types of clothes. Okay, when you go for a party, you wear party dress. When you go to school, then you wear school dress uniform, and at home you just wear casual dress. Okay, student, so we all wear different types of clothes. Okay, student, but why do we need clothes? We need clothes because our clothes protects us from heat, cold, wind, rain and insects bite. Okay, student, we wear different types of clothes in different season. Okay, student, yes or no?
Yes.
What type of clothes do we wear in summer? Can you tell me what types of clothes do we wear in summer? We wear cotton clothes in summer. But why do we wear cotton clothes in summer? We wear cotton clothes in summer because cotton clothes makes us feel comfortable. Okay, it is very hot during the summer. Okay, so cotton clothes makes us feel comfortable in summer. Okay, student. And in winters we wear woolen clothes. Why do we wear woolen clothes in winter? Because woolen clothes keeps us warm in the cold weather. Okay, we wear woolen clothes in winter because the woolen clothes keeps us warm in the cold weather. Okay, student. And in rainy season we use raincoats. In rainy season we use raincoats, gum boots, okay, umbrella. These all are made up of nylons. Okay, student, so the clothes we wear are made up of fibers. There are mainly two types of fibers. Okay, one is natural and other is synthetic. Okay, number one is natural, as the name shows that we get it from the nature. We get it from the nature because we get it from plants and animals. Okay, so the natural fiber, we obtain natural fiber from plants and animals. Okay, and from the fibers which we obtain from plants are cotton, jute, silk. Okay, student, the natural fiber we obtain from plants are cotton, jute. Okay, student, and jute. Okay, the natural fiber we obtain from plants is cotton and jute. Okay, and the natural fiber obtained from animals is wool. We get wool from the sheep. Okay, student, and silk from the silkworm. Okay, so these are the natural fiber obtained from the plants. Now the synthetic fiber. synthetic fiber or man-made fiber. Synthetic fiber is also known as man-made fiber because these are made by the man. Okay, student, and the example of synthetic fiber are nylon, rayon and polyester. Okay, student, you can see in the picture here, the cotton is the natural fiber obtained from plants. Natural fiber obtained from plants. And wool and silk are the natural fiber obtained from animals. Okay, student, so our clothes are made up of two types of fiber, natural fiber and synthetic fiber. Natural fiber we obtain from plants and animals, and synthetic fibers are man-made fibers. Okay, student, so the example of natural fiber are cotton, wool, silk, jute, etc. Okay, the natural fiber which we obtain from animals is cotton and silk, and the natural fiber we obtain from plants is cotton, jute. Okay, student, so clothes are made up of two types of fiber, natural and synthetic fiber, and we wear different types of clothes in different season. Okay, in summer we wear cotton clothes. Cotton clothes makes us feel comfortable. Okay, student, and in winter we wear woolen clothes. Woolen clothes keeps our body warm in winters. Okay, this was all about the clothes. Okay, student, so our clothes are made up of two types of fiber, natural fiber and synthetic fiber. Okay, student, natural fiber which we obtain from plants is cotton and jute. Okay, and the natural fiber which we obtain from animals is wool and silk. Okay, student, and the synthetic fibers are nylon, rayon and polyester. Okay, student, the student, we wear different types of clothes in different seasons. Okay, we wear different types of clothes in different seasons. Okay, we wear cotton clothes in summer. Why do we wear cotton clothes in summer? Can you guess? Can you tell me? Yes, cotton clothes absorbs the sweat, as it is very hot during the summer. Summer days are very hot, you all know, you are all familiar with this. Okay, so the cotton clothes absorbs the sweat and makes us feel comfortable during the summer. Okay, why do we wear cotton clothes in summer? We wear cotton clothes in summer because cotton clothes absorbs the sweat and makes us feel comfortable. Okay, student, and we wear woolen clothes during the winter. Why do we wear woolen clothes in winter? You all wear a lot of woolen clothes during the winter. Your sweaters, jackets, muffler, caps, socks. Okay, student, we wear a lot of woolen clothes during the winters. Why? Because woolen clothes keeps us warm during the extreme cold weather. Okay, thand se bachata hai hamari body ko, garam rakhte hain woolen clothes. इसलिए हम क्या करते हैं, विंटर्स में वी वेयर वुलन क्लोथ्स. ओके, सो वी वेयर वुलन क्लोथ्स इन विंटर बिकॉज वुलन क्लोथ्स कीप्स अस वार्म ड्यूरिंग द विंटर्स. ओके स्टूडेंट, वुलन क्लोथ्स कीप्स अस वार्म ड्यूरिंग द विंटर एंड ड्यूरिंग द रेनी सीजन. ड्यूरिंग द रेनी सीजन वी यूज क्लोथ्स मेड अप ऑफ नायलॉन. फॉर एग्जाम्पल, रेनकोट, अम्ब्रेला, गम बूट्स एक्सेट्रा. ओके, सो वी वेयर क्लोथ्स आर वेरी हेल्पफुल टू अस. व्हाई डू वी नीड क्लोथ्स? वी नीड क्लोथ्स बिकॉज क्लोथ्स प्रोटेक्ट अस फ्रॉम हीट, कोल्ड, विंड, रेन एंड इंसेक्ट बाइट. ओके स्टूडेंट, वी वेयर डिफरेंट टाइप्स ऑफ क्लोथ्स इन डिफरेंट सीजन्स. Clothes makes us look smart and presentable. Clothes, and as we need a house to live, or as a house protects us from heat, cold, wind and rain. In a similar way, our clothes protects us from heat, cold, rain and insect bite. Okay student, thank you. Up to here we have studied about the house, how does a house is important for us, how does clothes are important for us. We wear different types of clothes in different seasons, and clothes are made up of different types of fibers. Okay student, this was the revision of the chapter. You might have watched the earlier video also related to this chapter. Now this is one is the revision of this chapter. Okay student, so thank you everyone. Let's meet in the next video of science. Okay.